idea. Kana. There's a Kana over here. Cheerful humming, okay. Seems alright. Hi. Oh wow. These are a little crazy looking. Look at those sharp teeth. Just off the side of the path into Kanua stands an imposing figure. A tall, thick-set Aumaua clad in worn armor and peering up at the outer walls of the keep. In his hand is a small piece of charcoal, and it works feverishly at taking notes upon a small scrap of paper. More than once, he has to reach up to prevent his colorful cap from falling off his head as he gazes upwards. Excuse me. That moldy brickwork must be fascinating. The man looks at you, blinking in surprise. His face splits in a wide and very toothy grin, and he waves the parchment in greeting.
It is. Well, not the wall itself, perhaps. The construction is very traditional. There are names scratched upon some of the bricks, just there. Workers and masons, I expect, carving a little immortality for themselves. It's a fine keep, Kanua. 2 centuries to its name, and abandoned for nearly as long.
Okay, I was close. Kanua.
But the truly interesting part is in there. And I haven't had much luck in reaching the keep itself. I hoped to find the master of this place, a man by the name of Meyerwald. But it seems that he either holds his privacy most dear, or else has been devoured by his house guests.
Why haven't you gone inside? Well, it's just that there are a great many dangerous creatures between the keep and I did make an attempt, of course, and I was chased away by dark spirits. What do you want from Meyerwald?
Knowledge. Or, to be less clever about it, a certain text. I've come in search of a great treasure, you see. Not gold or silver, but the Tanvi Oratoa. You might call it the Book of Virtues. It's a sacred text of Rauatai, but we possess only a small fragment of it.
A year I've journeyed in search of the rest, and I found evidence suggesting that the original lies there, beneath the keep. I want to ask Meyerwald if he knows of it. And you, my friend? Why are you here? Yeah, let's try to keep the watcher stuff on the down low. I, too, wish to speak to Meyerwald. Truly? Then perhaps we can help one another. The grounds are infested with all manner of beasts. I've never seen the like. I didn't want to risk it alone, but you seem capable. Together, I'm sure we could manage it, and then we could both ask our questions of Meyerwald. Let's go meet Meyerwald, then.
Excellent. Lead on, my friend, and I will be at your heels. Ah, wait. Speaking of that, I ought to warn you first. Wondrous teeth, I nearly forgot. I have, at times, been followed. It began in Adir, and in Exometal they attacked outright. I believe they do not wish for me to find what I am looking for.
Who's following him?
I say believe, but I have been told as much by one of my would-be assassins. I paid them little mind. Humorless swords in long robes. But it's why I bought the sword, you see. And it's only fair that you should know.
You seem very calm about this.
Well, it's not as if I'm going to turn around and go home at their urging. If their previous efforts are anything to go by, we have very little to worry about.
Huh. Okay. We have a full party with this Kana person.
Yes.
Yes? What's all this? Oh, is he a bard? Oh, he's a chanter. Right. This game's version of bards. Uh, arquebus. Oh. Matchlock firearms of high power and fair accuracy. Arquebuses are prized for their ability to penetrate wizards' arcane veils. Oh, no, I didn't want to do that. And he's also got a fine estoc. These long, two-handed swords are easily distinguished from great swords by their narrow, spike-shaped blades. Estocs are not commonly used by warriors in the Deerwood, but their value against heavily armored opponents is undisputed. Fourth level chanter of the island of Aumaua. Background is Ratai, scholar. Now I have to read up about these chanters. I don't know that much about them.
Following your lead. Yes? It's good to be on the road again. A wanderlust is nothing rare in the people of Rauatai, but often I think myself alone in loving the land as much as the sea. What shall we see next, I wonder?
Tell me about yourself.
What shall I tell? I am Kanarua, born in the royal city of Tekoa, from which rules the Ranga Nui. There. That is a solemn enough start. I am a lore chanter in the college there. Or, at least, a student of lore and a chanter both.
Cool. The accent's right, but you don't look like you're from Rauatai. Do I not? He grins crookedly. I take your meaning. My family is from the Deadfire Archipelago. But I have never seen the islands. My parents traveled to Rauatai many years before I was born. They found more opportunity in Rauatai. My mother took to crafting cannons, aspiring pirate that she is, and my father's work with coral caught the eye of someone important, and then the Ranga Nui himself. The rest followed. What would you like to know? What is a Ranga Nui? A king. Our great king, ruler over all of Rauatai. He's led our people well, and he has treated my family very well. My father and he are great friends, as much as one can be friends with a king. What made you leave the college?
I was on the usual path at first. Theology, the traditions, when the Gate of Great Teeth was completed. It was all my father had hoped for. The greatest commission he had ever received. But it was also a sign that Rauatai was changing, looking inward. Meanwhile, I was neck deep in the writing of a dozen nations, marveling at all the things that lay beyond our borders.
And in so many of those books and records, I found accounts of ancient Angwith. The Adirians hold a great hunger for the Angwithan relics, and why shouldn't they? It was the civilization from which the Glanfathans learned to read souls. I decided that my third degree would be in history, and that I would study the Angwithans. They were at the heart of so much discussion abroad, so many discoveries. It drew some mockery. We'd watch Adir draw itself into several conflicts with the Glanfathans over these ruins. Takawa had its own concerns. And soon I found it, a section of the Tanvi Oratoa, in the Adirian translation of ancient Angwithan script. Just there, without explanation. It seemed like a gift from the gods. Tell me about the lore chanters. My eldest brother thinks we spend our days in song, weaving wreaths from flowers, but the truth is far less exciting than that. That's not exciting. That's supposed to be exciting. The college preserves what knowledge our people have gathered. I would have it said that the lore chanters are Rauatai, for without them, we would have no beginning, no sense of how far we've come. We would forget ourselves with every generation. I'm only a student yet, but someday I'll return and tell the Keeper what I learned, and she will add my verses to the chant. What is this Gate of Great Teeth? Much as it sounds, a maze of walls, like the teeth of some nautical terror. It sits outside the city and guards Takawa from invaders and storms. The storms have always been more trouble, New tannery, the angry titans throwing themselves against Rotai's shores. Invaders I'm not so sure about, but perhaps I'm like the man who, being dry, throws off his rain cloak during a storm. Kana laughs, so my mother would have me believe. Ask all you like. A chanter's purpose lies in the telling of stories. Mostly true stories, at that. Hmm. Tell me about Rautai.
Ah, Rautai. Shall I describe the pearl-white sands? The sapphire waters? The multi-hued tiles of the rooftops, like a mosaic upon the coast? Sorry.
Was there something specific you wanted to know? Tell me... It's gonna be a while. Tell me about the kingdom of Rautai in general. It's a long journey by ship to the north, past Ixamatil and... Did I get it right? I'm not sure. Past... Ixamatil? Ixamatil? No, that's not. Ixamatil? I don't know. And across the sea, we have settled much of the gulf and established more recent trading colonies all along the coast. We live as best we can, like anyone else. Our land is plagued by storms, and so we stand together, whatever corner of Rautai we hail from. Otherwise, we'd never survive. It sounds like you miss home. Some parts of it. The silver cliffs, the sea, those, at least, no one can change. The day I boarded the ship for Adir, the sunrise was gold upon the water, and I nearly leapt overboard and swam for home. Do only Aumaua live there? Far from it. The Aumaua arrived more recently and formed the greater number, but others have joined us, so long as they call themselves subjects of the Ranga Nui. Some of my neighbors are Orlans, for instance, fine people, though they care little for the sea. People here say that the coastal Aumaua are a cruel people. Cruel in the same manner that Orlans are feral and the pale elves graceful, yes? Kana chuckles. Aumaua conquered Rautai long ago, and drove their enemies from these lands in the doing of it. Today, the great kingdom of Rautai holds humans, Orlans, elves, even Island Aumaua. Kana flashes a quick smile. What a campaign of conquest says upon those responsible. You'll have to ask the Adirians. About, rather. In any case, the reputation persists. Good if you want fighting work. Less so if you would like to be a cook. Tell me about the city you're from, Takawa.
Takawa is doubly famed, a royal city and home to the Coral Harbor. The Ranga Nui's palace is there, and we've a fleet of royal ships sitting outside the Gate of Great Teeth. Every so often, you'll hear the roar of a cannon being tested.
The finest ships in Rautai, and so the world, are anchored there, and some of our brightest minds toil away at the artillery. My mother, for instance, Kana grins brightly. Myself, I have no talent with gunpowder. Takawa is also home to the Lore College, of course, and we get a great many people traveling long distances to speak with the Lore Keeper, or else hear the chants and peruse the books. At least, that is how it was when I was younger. Things were a little different when I left. How so? You might say the winds are changing. The Bahari, they are traditionalists, in a way. The Ranga Nui's son stands among their number. Talk at the dinner table has changed from how far a fleet of Rautai ship might sail to how well defended our borders are. How far we have turned from the old ways. So I guess, hold on a second. Trying to stop my voice from doing that. Then talk turns to borrowing Adirian and Valian merchant ships, and, Kana sighs, things were difficult when I left. There was much arguing among the elders. I trust the king has kept the peace, but I worry sometimes that things have taken a turn for the worse. It's sensible to look to your people's best interests. Of course. But I can't help but wonder if this is in our best interest. If we isolate ourselves from every other land, what do we sacrifice in exchange for a monumental... a momentary safety. But that's Rortai's lessons to learn. Perhaps I was foolish to think I could change its course on its behalf. I wasn't done talking. Oh, this is phrases. He has zero phrases. That's how you link different sentences together.
Yes? Yes, my friend?
How are you holding up? I'm ready if you are, Kana grins.
It's good to be on the road again. A wanderlust is nothing rare in the people of Rauatai, but often I think myself alone in loving the land as much as the sea. What shall we see next, I wonder?
So, these people who are after you. Hmm? Oh, them. Yes, I ran into them in Adir, or rather, they sought me out. In Adir, there were many people who had observed the Ingwithin ruins in the Deerwood, and I spent some time conferring with experts. In the libraries, I found accounts of sites in Ixamatil, and it was there I traveled next. But just before that, I found myself approached by a woman in dark robes who bade me abandon my studies for my own safety. I ignored it, of course, but I began to have the sense after that of being followed, and after that, well, one ambush on the road I could call misfortune, but three? Who are these people? I thought it only fair to delve into their activities in turn. I found word of a leaden key, but past that it was all ravings and superstitions. I might as well have gone around asking whether someone had ever seen a whale flying through the air. Some might well tell me yes, but the validity of their accounts is questionable. Is this the same? You don't seem worried about this. They haven't had much luck. The last one came up on me at a dig site and slipped in a muddy beam. I tried to catch him. Reflex, I should think, but he went right over the side and down 100 feet. I'm not really sure what he had in mind, but I doubt that was it. You're being hunted by the leaden key? So it seems. It's all rather absurd. What harm could I possibly do them by finding this text? Perhaps they don't like Rortai? How did all this begin? I ran into them in Adir, or rather they sought me out. In Adir there were many people who had observed the Ingwithin ruins in the Deerwood, and I spent some time conferring with experts. In the libraries, I found accounts of sites in Ixamatil, and it was there I traveled next. Yeah, same thing. What is this sacred book you're looking for?
The Tanvi Oratoa. It's not really a book. It's been passed down over the years in the form of a chant. I actually found it a little strange at first, seeing it set down in stone. It's not quite the same as a song of worship. Though we have paeans to the gods as well. More a kind of moral guide. It gives us something to aspire to. The, model of a virtuous citizen of Rauatai.
Why look for it out here?
There have been arguments as to the chant's true interpretation. New translations, even. But any rendition of it I find in the ruins of Ingwith will predate those translations by 2,000 years. And finding it here also proves that we still have much to gain from trading with other cultures.
Sounds a lot like James Earl Jones.
I'd be lying if I said I'm not looking forward to seeing the look on everyone's faces when I get back. But in the long term, I just think that we can learn a lot from the Ingwithians. A civilization like that is something to aspire to. A model for Rauatai as a whole, and not just its people. And I want to prove that all of this is worthwhile. Traveling, seeing the world for what it is. It's been so different from sitting in the Chanter Hall and studying books.
Won't it have crumbled away by now?
Much of Ingwith's writing is lost to us, but an engraving would survive. I found several tablets at the site in Ixamatil.
Ixamatil.
The scholar Gabranos, in particular, seems to have been fond of writing on the walls. I may have to ask you to help me carry it, if it's a large stone.
You came all this way just to win an argument?
More or less. It wasn't a popular theory when I suggested it. The idea that we shared the Tanvi Oratoha with some older culture, I mean, doesn't mean it's not true. It doesn't help that my family is from the Deadfire Islands. If I had a copper pond for every chanter who suggested that it's just not in my nature to conquer, my siblings, my parents, they make up for it. They build walls and cannons and ships. I've tried to explain. It isn't that I think those things aren't necessary, but if Rawatai closes itself off from trade, turns on its own people over tradition, we will fall behind, and then we'll be the ones getting conquered. I think my father tries to understand at least.
So describe this virtuous citizen.
Dutiful, learned, honest. The sticking point is loyal. Loyal to the people of Rawatai, above all others. Fearless in their defense, and bold in aspiration. Tireless in battle or industry. An inspiration to one's people. But it seems it's not that far a leap from there to the idea that we must cast out foreign influences.
Is that what you aspire to be?
Doesn't everyone want to be a good citizen?
Kana looks away. You think the Anguithans were the true authors?
I don't know that the distinction is necessarily important. Rawatai has a long history, and our people have come from many different places. It matters less who wrote it than that I have found pieces of the verses all around the world. Wherever it came from, it will be Rawatai that decides what becomes of it. All the races and peoples of our kingdom coming together to create a great empire. You see, then, that I am loyal in my way.
Do you know anything about this place? Kadnua is a marvel, an ugly, crumbling marvel. But even so, it's overshadowed by what it sits upon. But the keep itself can tell you much about the Edirian settlement. A very rigid people, I find. Let's be on our way.
Yeah.
I just want to have a little more for this episode. So we've rolled over to the next episode, so we're now 32.
No problem.
Try to see if we can clear off. I think we did clear off a little of the fog there.
Hello? Hello?
Why are you yelling hello? Can't go any further than that. Maya's going, hello, hello. Let's see what's up here, if anything. Skein bone. I guess we have that already.
Hmm.
So you can't do anything with that door. One shattered cask still smells faintly of ale long spilled into the dirt. Alright. Is that the way in? Oh, we can just go straight through. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna sign off here then, in that case. Thanks for watching. See you next time when we enter Kadnua itself, now with a party of six. I wonder if we find someone else, if we're gonna boot. We're gonna boot someone, or, or not allow someone else in? That'll be interesting to say. Thanks for watching. Enduring, grow strong.